Let's discuss about the Born-Haber cycle. What do you mean by this one? That is also nothing but the energy factors involved in the formation of the ionic bond. Just now we have seen the how the ionic bond which is going to be formed, right? So that is what are the energy factors will be there behind this one. Let's take here. So that is called the formation of the one more formation of this sodium chloride crystal, that is in the form of solid state, which is going to be obtained by the combination of the one more of the sodium metal in solid state and also gathering the half mole of the chlorine gas, that is in the form of the gaseous state. We are going to obtain this sodium chloride crystal, that is in the form of solid state. And this is delta HF is nothing but the enthalpy, right? The formation of this enthalpy of formation of this NaCl compound, and Q is nothing but the amount of energy which we are going to measure in the kilo joule. So let's take, so in order to understand this one, let's take some of the reactions below this one. So first I am going to take the step 1 for this one. So this step 1 we are going to call as the enthalpy of sublimation, that is called enthalpy of sublimation. So in this first step, what happens? We are going to take the one mole of the sodium metal, right? Sodium metal in the solid state. So it is going to be converted into same one mole of the gaseous form. So that is called, in order to conversion of the solid to gaseous, the energy that we are going to call as the sublimation energy, conversion of the solid into gaseous form. That's you are going to take in camphor, right? Camphor, when you are going to heat this one, the black sublimation of the fog which is coming out, smoke is coming out, right? So that is called sublimation process. Conversion of solid into gaseous, that is called sublimation. Here also sodium metal, it is usually in solid state. In order to conversion of this gaseous, we are going to call the sublimation energy. So this process is called the enthalpy of sublimation, that we are going to indication as the delta HS plus Q1 kilo joule, means the amount of energy. Say around the plus 105 point something kilo joule will be there. So let's take the second step. So enthalpy of ionization. Ionization means the amount of energy which is going to require the one electron from its outermost, that is called in the gaseous form of this sodium metal, which is going to lose us one electron, right? So that process we are going to call as delta HI. I means enthalpy of the ionization. 492.7 kilojoule will be there. So this is called the second step. After getting this Na plus, now we are going to call the step 3. Step 3 we are going to call as the enthalpy. Enthalpy is nothing but it is in the thermodynamic world, it is nothing but the formation of one energy. Enthalpy of the dissociation. Enthalpy of dissociation. How it is going to dissociate means we are going to use the half mole of the chlorine gaseous molecule, right? It is called conversion of this half chlorine gaseous, half mole of the chlorine gases into this form, Cl gaseous form. So it is called dissociation. Now it is going to be dissociation because the two half mole of this chlorine molecule which can be dissociated to form the chlorine gas of the one form of the atom. That is named called as the delta HD, or we are going to call as the, this is Q3 kilojoule. Q means sum of the amount of energy will be there. This is called Q2 kilojoule. This is called Q1 in kilojoule. So after getting this chlorine, our next step is in order to conversion of this Cl minus, right? So that is step 4, we are going to call as the that is called the gain enthalpy, electron gain enthalpy. So this conversion of this, now it is become this chlorine atom, right? So that is in the form of gaseous, right? So this requires the high electron gain enthalpy to be there. That is called, it is going to obtain one electron. How it is going to obtain from one electron from this sodium metal. So now I am going to trend as the gaseous form of this chlorine atom, which is going to acquire one electron, that is called electron gain enthalpy. Now it is going to form as this Cl minus, that should be in the form of the gaseous. So its name is called delta HEG, means electron gain enthalpy. So its value will be around Q4 kilojoule. And we should write this, what is the amount of energy? That is called negative. Why it is called negative? So these are all the positive energy. Whatever this is negative because of the electron gain enthalpy. It means energy is going to be released. But here the energy is going to be obtained here, right? Energy is going to obtain to remove an electron. That is called positive. In terms of the energy will be the positive. But whereas here the energy which is going to be released when you are going to add an electron to this chlorine atom. Now it is in the form of the negative. And obviously you know that it is called step 5. Step 5 we are going to call as the, that is enthalpy, indicating as the U, capital letter U. So how it is going to be obtained here? That is called Cl minus and Na plus. So that is combining of the one mole of the gaseous form of this sodium positive plus say one mole of the chlorine, that is in the form gaseous ionic form, it is going to obtain the Na Cl. So that is called delta H is equal to U. U is nothing but the lattice enthalpy. That is also in the form of the kilo joule will be there. So this is explained as the Born-Haber cycle. So first you should take the delta HF. How it is going to be obtained? Delta HF, that is called enthalpy of the formation. Now we are going to add all these energy because the energy factors involved in the formation of ionic bond. So in order to form this NaCl bond, what are the energy will be going? You are going to add them. That is called delta HF is equal to, this is for first one, delta HS plus delta HI, that is for enthalpy of ionization, plus third one delta HD, dissociation enthalpy, delta HD plus next gain enthalpy, delta HEG, last one is for, that is U, delta H is nothing but here U, U will be there. So now we are going to require this U. U means lattice enthalpy, U is equal to, now I am going to U. U means U, if I take separate means, that is I am going to write as delta HF as it is. So now it is in the plus form there. Now it is after coming this equal sign left side, they are becoming the negative values now. Delta HF minus delta HS minus delta HI minus delta HD minus delta HEG, all in the form of the negative because we are going to obtain this lattice enthalpy, means delta HF minus delta HS minus delta HI minus delta HD minus delta HEG, that is equal to U. This is called lattice enthalpy. So let's define this word, that is called lattice enthalpy. Lattice enthalpy is nothing but the energy is liberated. Here you are going to see here the various amount of energy is various liberated here. So these are called as the amount of energy is going to be liberated to form the one mole of the ionic compound, one mole of the ionic compound of this sodium chloride. So this is called Born-Haber cycle.